In this section, we will learn about team life cycle. How team life cycle works from setting up of the team and completion of the project. So you have a Six Sigma project which you want to initiate. You get number of people from number of departments. These people work together as a team, and once the project is completed, these people go back to their own work. So they get out of the team. How things work from the beginning to end. This team life cycle, which was developed by Tuckman, it's also called as Tuckman's model. This explains how team dynamic works. As per this theory, there are five stages of team. These stages are forming, when you form the team, then storming. During the storming, people try to understand each other. They have disagreements with each other. That is the storming phase of the team. So you form the team, you put people together. People were new, not knowing each other. Then they started having disagreement in the storming phase. Then comes the norming stage, when people start working as a team. In the norming stage, rules are set up. People know how to behave, how to act in the team. Once that stage is reached, the next stage is performing. This is the stage when most of the work, a big creative work, is done, when the team work as a single team to achieve the common objective. That is the performing stage of the team. And once the team has achieved the objective, then the last stage is adjourning. Adjourning is when the team is broken down, breaking of the team, and going back to their own workplaces when the task is complete. So each team, when formed, goes through these five stages. Let us talk about these five stages on next few slides in a little bit more detail. Starting with the first stage of team formation, this is forming. This is when the team is formed. People from different groups are brought together to work as a team. Since people don't know each other, there is sort of an apprehension. Here you need a strong leader, because the team depends on leader to tell them what to do. Idea creations are simple because team doesn't know each other, so everyone is being kept to himself or herself. Since people don't know each other, they keep their ideas and thoughts to themselves only. There is a tendency to avoid controversy because everyone is a stranger there, and there is no serious topic discussion also, and there is a minimum feedback because the team is just formed. So what leader needs to do at this time is leader needs to direct. So this is what I'm putting here. Leader directs in the forming stage because someone has to firmly tell team members what to do, because team members do not know each other. They are apprehensive of the situation, and this is the time when leader needs to take a strong position and direct the team towards the goal. So this is the first stage of the team formation. Coming to the next stage, which is storming. Storming is the time when people start expressing their views. Each one has their own strong view towards that goal. They have a strong position towards that. They challenge each other's idea, because this is the time when they want to dominate the group and want to show their position. The team will even challenge the leadership position or authorities during this stage of the team formation. Some team member even might withdraw, because they don't agree with other members, so they might even want to withdraw at this time. There is a lack of collaboration and there is a competition for taking control of the team. As a team leader, your role at this time is to coach and help people to move towards the goal. Coming to the next stage of team formation, which is norming. Once the storming has been done, once people have fought for their position, once they have challenged the situation, now people slowly adjust to the situation and start to learn about the team. This is the stage which is known as norming. Here people listen to each other, people find a way to work together, and they are ready to change their views along with other team members. They are receptive to other team members' ideas and actively participate in the team. If there's any conflict, that conflict is seen as a common problem, not as an individual problem. So every member looks at the problem as the group problem, not the individual problem. And then there is an open exchange of ideas. So that was the stage number three, which is norming. And the role of leader at this time is to facilitate the team, facilitate to help them take their own decisions. So the team takes decision at this time and the leader just helps them in taking those decisions. Coming to the fourth stage of team formation, which is performing. This is the time that team is most productive. They are highly creative. They have been together for some time. The disagreement which they had with each other have been resolved now during storming and norming stage. Now they are in performing stage. They have a strong relationship. They make bond with each other. The personal bonding develops during this time and the achievements are high at this time. Team is working in full swing. What leader needs to do at this time is just delegate. Leave decision making and everything to the team members and take a backside position. So that's the role of leader at the stage of performing. So leader delegates at this stage. Coming to the last stage of team, which is adjourning. Adjourning comes when the project objective has been achieved. When the project objective have been achieved, now there is a breakdown of team because team members have to go back to their own places. So team is breaking up at this time. They hope that they will meet next time on some other improvement project or some other work together as a team. This is the time team leader need to recognize the efforts made by team members. And many a times people are vulnerable at this time because they don't know what will happen to them. If this was a project and they don't have another project to go to, so people are apprehensive of that. So this is the time that team leader needs to communicate to reassure them, recognize them and recommend them for the next project if they have done the good job. So that's the role of leader at this stage, which is adjourning. So these are the five stages which each team has to go through. Understanding these five stages will definitely help you when you work as a Six Sigma team leader. You know that what stage your team is at and based on that, what sort of a strategy you need to take, whether you need to delegate, whether you need to coach, whether you need to facilitate, whether you really need to direct them. So all that will depend on what stage your team is at.